Hey everyone, Jason here. A couple of weeks ago, LEGO announced their upcoming Forma line of sets, and the first one being a small kinetic sculpture of a swimming fish. And personally, I'm not too keen on the plastic skins that they're using for them, but I was super intrigued with the mechanism they're using to get the swimming motion. So based on the videos and photos that they posted, I was able to reverse engineer the core Technic frame that they're using, which is this right here. And I thought it would be an interesting challenge to try and build a brick built skin for it. And so I built this shark. I had a lot of fun designing the reef, actually. It was really cool to kind of dig through parts to find some interesting ones to make the different coral plants. And I seem to use an excessive amount of food, actually. There's sausages here, some carrots, and some ice cream. I even used some hair pieces. Here's some wavy female hair, and there's some green spiky hair over here. I used some old Clickets pieces here to get these kind of tubular plants. And these are old jellyfish from the SpongeBob line of sets. I also added a little school of fish swimming underneath the shark. The shark itself is pretty straightforward. It's mostly built out of curved slopes, just clad onto the side of the Technic frame. And I did find this printed shark piece from an old 2007 Aqua Raiders set I had. I also modified the mechanism slightly from the original Forma frame. I basically just dampened the motion of the head a little bit because I thought it was a little too aggressive in the original model. And I also de-synchronized the motion of the head with the tail. In the original, they are completely in sync. And I think those two changes combined to give it a little more natural looking swimming motion. So how does it all work? We'll start by taking a look at the stock Forma frame. It is pretty cool. It's very compact, very simple, easy to put together, and it still results in some pretty complex motion. It's all driven by a single crank on this end here, which through the gears underneath just drives this orange crank, which drives that white piston. And I'll take off a few of these lift arms so that we can more easily see what's going on. The two body segments follow the motion of these two lift arms here, and that white piston pushes the ends of each of those lift arms from side to side. The lift arms are anchored in their center so that the opposite end of each of them basically moves from side to side as well, but completely out of phase with the center. And that's how you get the body twisting from side to side. The head and the tail are each fixed to these two support axles here, and they each have a lever at the bottom which can control their orientation. And those levers are connected directly to that orange crank as well. So that single crank controls all of the motion. So as we rotate the crank, they influence the lever and move the head and the tail. Now, one thing to note is that because the head and the tail are both driven by the same crank, and they have the same geometry, that they always maintain the same orientation throughout their motion. Now let's take a look at my custom version of the base. The back half of the body and the tail are controlled in the exact same way as on the original, using this orange crank. But I've added a secondary crank here, this yellow one, to control the motion of the head. And as you can see, it's shorter than the orange crank. The length of the yellow crank is only half a stud compared to one stud being the length of the orange crank. You'll also notice that it's a little bit out of phase with the orange crank, and that is how I decoupled the synchronized motion of the head and the tail. The other thing I did is that I changed the anchor point for the front of the body. This lift arm, instead of being anchored at its center, it's now anchored a little bit closer to the front. And as a result, the center of the body still moves from side to side with a range of two studs, but the front of the body only moves from side to side with a range of one stud. When we put all of that together, we basically decreased all aspects of the motion of the head and the front of the body by a factor of two. And we've also offset the motion of the head a little bit from the motion of the tail. And that is about all there is to it. I'm really looking forward to what else comes out of this Forma line. I think there's a lot of potential for some cool mechanisms to come out of future sets. If you want to see more cool custom LEGO creations, be sure to subscribe. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you next time.